Hypoxia is a low oxygen concentration in the blood. Cyanosis is visible blueness due to increased levels of deoxygenated haemoglobin. They may go together, but they're not the same thing. Peripheral cyanosis, that is blue extremities, may be a normal finding, especially if you're cold. Central cyanosis, when inside the lips, tongue, or mucous membranes are blue, is never normal. In this case, more than 4 gram of haemoglobin per 100 ml is deoxygenated due to either low blood oxygen concentration or a right-to-left shunt. That's a hole in the heart that allows systemic venous blood to bypass the lungs and enter the left heart, mixing with the systemic arterial blood. So, what about hypoxia? Why doesn't cyanosis appear whenever the oxygen concentration in blood is low? Recall the hemoglobin-oxygen dissociation curve. The sigmoid shape tells us that hemoglobin will stay relatively well saturated, over 90% in fact, until the partial pressure of oxygen in the blood falls below 70 millimeters mercury. So, while blood oxygen concentrations are low, there isn't enough deoxyhemoglobin to cause cyanosis. So we use a finger oximeter to monitor oxygen saturation and alert us to hypoxia before the clinical sign of cyanosis appears. Approach to hypoxia. If someone is hypoxic, they're usually breathless as they increase respiratory effort. Always take a respiratory rate. If it isn't high, there's something seriously wrong. If the patient is hospitalized, consider excessive sedation or narcotics used for pain. Outside hospital, head injury may also reduce respiratory drive. Underventilation is a medical emergency. It needs to be recognized and treated quickly. How to correct hypoxia? Most important, treat the underlying cause. You can increase the inspired oxygen content by low-flow nasal prongs or even a high-flow mask. This usually improves arterial hypoxia because whatever the cause, some alveoli are relatively underventilated. If administering oxygen is ineffective, there is likely an extreme mismatch between ventilation and perfusion, such as with collapsed lung or major pulmonary embolism. In these cases, mechanical ventilation will be required. Finally, a word of caution. In patients with chronic airflow limitation, the drive to breathe comes from falling oxygen saturation. That is, they have hypoxic drive. Giving these patients high-flow oxygen may depress their ventilation, so be careful. Low-flow oxygen by nasal prongs at 2 liters per minute is unlikely to cause harm.